Koblenz, Germany has a great history and is an interesting city to visit. Join us in our exploration tour. Hello everyone, we are Henny and Joseph. We enjoy traveling and are fascinated by places with seas, beaches and rivers. In this video we tell you something about the past and the present of Koblenz. And stay until the end where we tell what you can do in Koblenz. Enjoy the video! One of the oldest German cities, two rivers, four castles, a well-preserved center, and a great cuisine. That is Koblenz. Nestled at the confluence of the mighty Rhine and Moselle rivers, Koblenz is a German city that exudes historical charm and modern vitality. The city's name originates from the Latin confluentes, which aptly describes its geographic significance at the meeting point of these two iconic waterways. With a rich history dating back millennia and a stunning natural backdrop, Koblenz stands as a captivating destination that beckons travelers to explore its wonders. Its roots trace back to Roman times, when it was a military post in the heart of the Roman Empire. Koblenz was established by Drusus around 8 BC. We know that guy. Look at the video about mines. Throughout its history, Koblenz found itself at the crossroads of empires and dynasties, resulting in a rich tapestry of architectural styles. Romans, Prussians, French and more all left their marks in the cities. Roman fortifications, medieval castles and baroque palaces coexist harmoniously, painting a picture of the city's evolution through time. The city's resilience is a testament to its enduring spirit as it survived wars, conquest and political upheavals to emerge as a thriving modern metropolis. In the present day, Koblenz continues to shine as a jewel in Germany's crown. The city effortlessly blends its historical treasures with contemporary life. In 1992, Koblenz celebrated its 2000th anniversary. The city is one of the oldest in Germany. Koblenz has 115,000 inhabitants, but is the center of a large region. The bustling ports of Koblenz continues to be hubs of activity, connecting the city to global trade networks. Cargo ships glide along the rivers. Visitors can watch as vessels navigate the currents or embark on leisure river cruises to experience the enchanting landscape from a unique perspective. Walking through its street is like stepping into a living museum, where cobblestone lanes wind past centuries-old buildings that now house modern shops, cafes and galleries. The fusion of past and present creates a unique ambience that enchants both locals and visitors. The Church of St. Castor was built between 817 and 836 by Hatto, the Archbishop of Trier, with the support of Emperor Louis the Pious. It is the oldest church in Koblenz. Under the tower clock of this building, built in 1724, you can see the eye roller, who moves his eyes back and forth in time with the clock's pendulum and sticks out his tongue every hour and half hour. It commemorates the robber Baron Johann Luther von Koblenz, who was executed on the Florence Mark in 1536. According to the legend, he rolled his eyes on the scaffold a stuck his tongue out at the spectators. Koblenz owes much of its identity to the majestic rivers that cradle its shores. The Rhine and Moselle converge in a graceful dance, forming a breathtaking backdrop for the city. Along the riverbanks, promenades offer many spots to enjoy panoramic views of the water. The Rhine is the second longest river in Central and Western Europe, after the Danube, at about 1,230 kilometers. The river begins in the southeastern Swiss Alps. After that, the Rhine defines much of the Franco-German border. It flows in a mostly northerly direction through Germany, before it turns into westerly direction and flows into the Netherlands, but eventually empties into the North Sea. There are two German states named after the river, North Rhine-Westphalia and Rhineland-Palatinate. The Moselle is a river that rises in the Vosges Mountains and flows through northeastern France and Luxembourg to western Germany. It is a left bank tributary of the Rhine, which it joins at Koblenz. The length of the river is 560 km. For 39 km, it forms the border between Germany and Luxembourg. It is very famous for the many vineyards around the river. The place where the Moselle flows into the Rhine is known as the German Corner. In 1897, a monument to German Emperor William I of Germany, mounted on a 14-meter tall horse, marks the confluence, symbolizing unity and resilience. The architect was Bruno Schmitz, who was responsible for several nationalistic German monuments and memorials. Due to its strategic location and the fact that it is a mountainous area, many fortifications and castles have always been built in and around Koblenz. There are four in the city itself, but many more in the vicinity. The Fort Grand Duke Konstantin, named after the brother of the Russian Emperor Konstantin Pavlovich, was built in 1822 until 1827. The facility was built under the direction of the Prussian military engineers Kettner and Schulbart. Electoral Palace was the residence of the last Archbishop of Trier, Clemens Wenceslaus of Saxony, who commissioned the building in the late 18th century. It now houses various offices of the federal government. Fort Altenstein was built in the new Prussian style between 1818 and 1826, as part of the Prussian fortresses of Koblenz and Ehrenbreitstein. Ehrenbreitstein Fortress is located in a strategic location with a view over Koblenz and Bos rivers. The current fort was built around 1815, after the French blew up the previous one. But there was already a fortress 1000 years before Christ. The fortress can be reached by cable car and offers great views of Koblenz and surroundings. Koblenz offers a myriad of activities that cater to every taste and interest. Stroll through the old town and be amazed by the architecture. The gastronomy is also top-notch. Many restaurants and bars offer something for everyone. Here you have two boulevards to walk along, the Rhine and the Moselle. A boat tour on the rivers is also recommended. There are many possibilities. The lush landscapes are a testament to the city's agricultural heritage, with vineyards producing some of Germany's finest wines. Koblenz boasts a captivating array of museums that delve into various facets of its history and culture. The Ludwig Museum is a museum of contemporary art. The emphasis of the collection is mainly on the classic works from the German, American and especially French art scene after 1945. The Mieterwijn Museum is a treasure trove of artifacts, paintings and sculptures that chronicle the city's journey through the ages. For those intrigued by the city's military past, it showcases an extensive collection of military equipment and technology. In the same building is the Romanticum, an interactive museum that immerses visitors in the romantic allure of the wine region. It offers a multi-sensory experience, blending history, legend and natural beauty into an engaging narrative. Ehrenbreitstein houses several museums, house of photography, house of archaeology, and the Landesmuseum Koblenz with temporary exhibitions. The history of Koblenz, etched into its architecture and culture, seamlessly entwines with its vibrant contemporary life. Koblenz's cultural scene reflects its diverse influences and the cosmopolitan outlook of its residents. As the rivers Rhine and Moselle continue to flow, so does the timeless spirit of the Koblenz, inviting travelers to become part of its living narrative. Thank you so much for watching. Leave a comment and please subscribe and press on the like button.